Hi, this is Shane Kennedy with your Point Park Athletics podcast update. The Pioneers men's basketball team went 2-0 over the past week, which started out with an 84-51 victory at Carlo. The Pioneers outscored the Celtics 64-25 over the final 24 minutes to pull away. Sharon Shafino had 13 points and Jordan Stowe had 12, as 12 different players scored. Point Park followed that up with a 77-74 overtime win over Rio Grande on Saturday. Shafino had 19 points, including the tying basket at the end of regulation to send it into overtime. That basket capped a 15-5 run as the Pioneers erased a 10-point deficit with 4 minutes to go. Garrett McHenry had 14 points and made the winning free throws in overtime. Jesse Calloway added 10 points. The Pioneers are off until February 9th, home versus Ohio Christian. The Point Park women's basketball team lost a shootout at Rio Grande on Saturday, 108-106. The Pioneers were facing big deficits the first three quarters, but they battled and trailed by one entering the fourth. Despite 25 points from Michelle Burns and 22 from Taylor Kirshner, the Pioneers were edged out at the end. Laura Davis had 18 points, and Taylor Wren added 12. The Pioneers went to Carlo on Tuesday night looking for a bounce-back win. The Pioneers led 36-25 at halftime and outscored Carlo 41-34 to earn the 77-59 victory on the road. Michelle Burns led the team with 23 points, and she drained 5 three-pointers. Taylor Wren had 17 points and 22 rebounds. Taylor Kirshner and Sierra Sonetta each had 11 points in the win. Point Park's next game is February 9th at Ohio Christian. The men's and women's indoor track and field team competed for the third straight week when they went to the YSU Mid-Major on Friday and Saturday. Alyssa Campbell headlined the women's side, running the number one time in the NAIA for the 3,000 meters. Her time of 9 minutes and 50 seconds was a 30-second personal record. She now ranks first in the country in the 3,000 and second in the mile. The women had their distance medley relay run a time of 12:58 to rank sixth in the nation. For the men's team, Damir Steven Stewart highlighted the Pioneers, placing third in the triple jump and also making the finals of the 60 meters. The long jump had Steven Stewart in fourth and Dumir Lomax in fifth, and Nasir Galloway was fourth in the shot put as other top placements. The next meet for both teams is February 6th at the Ohio Christian Trailblazers Invitational. The esports program took on Ivy League school Columbia University for week 2 of the League of Legends spring season. The match was knotted up at 1-1 after two sets, but Columbia was able to take the match 2-1 with some clutch moves at the very end of the third game. The Pioneers had consistent kills throughout the match with 76 on the day. The match lasted well over an hour, with the Pioneers giving their biggest battle of the year. Stay tuned for the next match, which will be announced soon by the league. The competitive cheer team faced Lourdes University for a virtual meet on Sunday night. The Pioneers improved their scores from the previous week, but came up with losses in both of the rounds of the dual meet. Point Park posted scores of 75 and 72, which were increases from the opening weekend with scores of 68 and 69. Lourdes scored in the 80s both times to win. The cheer team will face Mount Vernon Nazarene on Friday night for two matches. The competitive dance team had its second meet of the year and returned to the floor for the first time in 2 weeks with Sunday night's virtual competition. The Pioneers came out on top of the other two teams in attendance, which were Madonna and Lawrence Tech. The Pioneers had a final score of 66, which, although not their best of the year, was still able to beat Madonna with a 41 and Lawrence Tech with a 36. This has been Shane Kennedy with your Point Park Athletics podcast update.